currently bothered by the clawing attentions of the male sex? Well, here's the solution for you. Get Ruth Sherwood's new bestseller, 100 Easy Ways to Lose a Man. Chapter 1. Now, first way to lose a man. You met a charming fellow, and you're out for a spin. The motor fails, and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, oh, what a romantic spot we're in. Just get out front of the car, tell him it's the gasket, fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a sure way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game, you sit knee to knee. He says, the next guy up to bat will bunt, you'll see. Don't say, oh, what's a bunt? This game's too hard for little me. Just say, bunt, what are you, nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and the left-handed batter coming up, walk right into a triple play, like it happened in the fifth game of the World Series in 1923. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base. 98 ways to go. The third way to lose a man. Just push his head underwater, yell, last one in to run, and race him back to shore. That's a fine way to lose a man. You found your perfect mate, and it's been love from the start. He whispers, you're the one to who I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, my dear. Let's never, never part. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, make the use of the word whom imperative, which I can easily show you by trying.